3, 2, 1.
It is live stream start. Got the television activated.
All right. Let's give this a go. Good evening. I didn't announce this because I'm just sort of still... This track playing now is Shogun Nautilus on Renegade. I have a feeling I actually did a remix of this. Or another Shogun track, maybe. Not to be confused with the label Shogun, of course. Or maybe, I don't know, I've forgotten my history here. Maybe, nah, Friction wasn't Shogun. Anyway, yeah, we could. That's one for the Wikipedia Massive chat. That's your first Twitch mission, is to look up who did Shogun Nautilus EP. And if they had any link to Friction. Is the mic at a decent level, by the way? Can you hear me? Thanks, good. Glad the mic's the right level. Hope you like my shirt, by the way. I wore it especially for America today, Independence Day. You know I love you. This is 100% live today. I'm live streaming. I'm checking the chat. This isn't some pre-recorded stuff. Sorted all the visuals out myself. I can see Robert's asking if I'm going to be the Metalheads takeover in November at Egg in London. I don't know. I haven't been contacted about it yet, but they might not have booked people yet and be putting it together. So hopefully that would be nice. I'd be well up for it. I've got my gas mask. So even if COVID's running riot, I can go in there in my respirator. But that'll be good. Ah, good, the alerts are working. Netcola, thanks for the follow on Twitch. Can you hear the Alan Partridge when that happens? Does he go, aha? Ah, I forgot to hit record on the stream, so I might not do this as a podcast. This is a special for those of you that bothered to tune in when you saw the notification. Debreca 5, thank you. Oh, it's Derek. Sorry, I thought it was a Deborah. Man, I haven't heard this tune in like 20 years. I used to love it. Oh, what a tune. So nice to play tunes like this again. Even when these tunes were around the first time, they weren't really what I would play out in the clubs. But I always had the most fun just having little mix-up sessions at home, so it's really nice to come back to that. So if there's, and this time there's some people out there on the internet listening as well, which is great, rather than like my roommates at university like banging on the door, so John, can you turn out music? Well, actually my roommates at university were pretty supportive, but they did put up with a lot. Oh, this was such a swerve classic, this. Carlito. It says Grapevine here, but on the white labels, I never know which track was which, so Grapevine might have been the B-side. This is a classic to me anyway, but it's mad that I don't know if this is called Grapevine or if the other side is called Grapevine. But according to, I've written Grapevine on this side, so I'm gonna take 20 years in the past John B's word for it. We'll be right back. Omni Trio. Thanks to everyone in the chat. I am 100% live here, guys. This is not some fake bullshit stream that's pre-recorded. I'm checking the chat. Oh, thanks for the cheer, San the Sim. I'm trying to keep an eye on all the updates on the activity when the alerts come in, if you've subscribed and followed and all that stuff. So I'll give you a shout out if I see it. And it's much appreciated. Flip that Carlito one over. I'm going to play the other side as well because both sides are wicked, and I quickly listened to that one before. I was like, I've got to play this. So many memories. Somehow I have memories from Swerve, despite usually drinking at least a bottle of horrible red wine in there. And all my Swerve memories are drunk ones. If you're young and you do not know, Swerve was an amazing drum and bass night in London run by Fabio and Sarah Groove Connection, and it was like, it was my favourite drum and bass club ever. Played this kind of stuff, musical, liquid funk. I guess that's what I'm playing tonight. I don't know, I've just pulled out a bunch of records that I remembered and aced, so there you go. I hope this is good for your Saturday night. This feels really weird, like talking to a crowd and I'm just looking out into my like empty ghostly loft. To Greg in Houston watching on Facebook over there. Big up to the Texas Massive. Still feels pretty bad. Like, when I used to play this tune, I think I was still a student sitting in my little university room, and now I'm playing the same record in the middle of a global pandemic, streaming on the internet, saying hello to somebody I met in Houston, Texas, who's watching the whole thing in live HD video right now, the other side of the world. Mental. But hey, cool. The tune still sounds just as good. And to all my American followers, happy Independence Day. Hope you like the t-shirt. out to Laurie and Derek in Orlando, watching live on Facebook right now. How you doing? What a tune! This is Johnny L. Oh, another one I'd forgotten about. This is banging. Everyone in the chat, I am checking your messages. I've got my iPad here in front of me and I can see the messages come up. It's nice to see everyone getting involved who's watching. Thank you. Glad you're all liking the crabs. A bit rusty, sorry for the train wrecks. So that last one I think was called Underwater Communication. Either that or Symbiosis. It's by Johnny L. Off an album of his, which I should be able to recognise from the artwork, but I can't. Don't think it's Sawtooth, that was a 10-inch one. That's usually a good sign I like the track if I've scribbled on it. Hello to Ashley Alexander from Dover. Big up all the Dover crew. Up in Lincolnshire. Nice one. I don't know what kind of radio DJ voice I'm starting to put on. It sounds like a combination of Alan Partridge and like some famous drum and bass MCs. Nice one. And now it's time for the traffic updates. Oh yeah, and I was going to say, if you're watching this on Facebook, you should probably move over to Twitch, because Facebook has a habit of cutting off live streams. I think I put a little graphic that pops up every now and then on the screen saying that, but yeah, if you're watching on any other platform, I'd recommend currently going to Twitch, because if the music gets cut out where you are, it'll keep going on Twitch. Hopefully. Oh, this is going to show up weird because it's a green sleeve, so the green screen thing is going to project onto it. This is a V Recordings promo sleeve. These are beautiful artifacts from Drum and Bass. About having this mix on MP3 later, I should be able to rip it off Twitch and upload it, so yes, probably. I forgot to press record on the laptop when I'm streaming, but it'll get recorded as a video on demand on Twitch, so it might not be like super high quality MP3, but yeah, we'll have this with my speaking on top though, so sorry about that. So how's the video looking on all your platforms on Facebook and YouTube and Twitch? I saw a couple of comments there saying transcoding on Twitch is a bit buffery. I don't think that's anything I can do. It's like Twitch server side, but I know I'm sending everything out like no frames dropping. It's looking banging. But I'm keeping an eye on the chat here because we are live and direct. I've got Twitch open here. There's like a slight delay of like about 5 seconds on what I see. But I've got all your chat stuff. We've got some Russians in the place. Nikita. Flatulent Gonad just hosted the stream. Thank you very much, Flatulent Gonad. Wicked. And if you guys are watching on Twitch and you have an Amazon Prime account, I'm sure you know this already. The thing keeps popping up, but if you're an Amazon Prime subscriber, you get like one free Twitch sub. There's instructions how to do that on my Twitch thingy, and it basically gives me a couple of dollars or something like that. So if you're not subscribing to anyone else more worthy, then do a sub. That'd be great. I think it pops up on my screen as well, so I'll give you a shout out when I see that. But you're under no obligation. Just chill out and listen to the music. Right, I need to decide what I'm going to play next. This is DJ Trace, by the way. One of my favourite tunes of his, but it's obviously not the Reese heavy Trace that you know now. Is saying, damn, it's a shame you don't speak Russian. I know a few words from my time touring. Привет, Россия, меня зовут Джон Би, как дела? Заебись, пиздец, отлично. Отлично. Wow, all of these tunes I've picked so far have mixed really nicely into each other, if you sort of ignore the odd train wreck. Like, they're all in, seem to be in the right key and that. Nice happy accident. My first official vinyl sessions mix. Seen some comments here saying, oh, DJing looks like it's hard on the back. Yeah, I need to sort out my posture, get the microphone down a bit. I've got the complication of this, the roof here, like, trying to not hit my head. And I'm not used to, like, crouching down to flick through my records. Like, I haven't had to do that for 20 years. It's normally just like, da-da-da, Serato. So I've got to relearn a few things here. This track playing now is by the Funky Technicians. I think it's on Timeless Recordings, which was out in from Oxford. They were one of the vinyl distribution labels. And Funky Technicians, one of them was Q Project. I didn't read the label, so I apologies for not remembering who the other half of Funky Technicians was, but I think it's someone that's still around now as well. This was a tune I was very pleased to find in this pile. So a Flytronics remix of DJ Pulse. I remember this being played at like speed, I think, and like getting rewound about 5, 6, 7 times. Like, so, oh my God. Sounds simple by today's standards, but oh my God. There we go. I don't know if the internet called for the rewind there, but I did. John B. 25 years ago called for the rewind. Ah, oh, I bought this at Trax Records. Was that the shop in Durham, Newcastle, in Sunderland? DJ Pulse and the Jazz Cartel. Destiny, the Flytronics remix. Certified banger! I need my button for that, but it's on the other setup. Denver crew represent! Sorry, I'm in darkness here, apart from the lights that are on me. And I don't want to start having ghostly visions of something like crawling towards me along the floor. Thanks, Magda. Big ups to everyone tuned in right now. I am live on Twitch and Facebook and YouTube and the whole internet. Big up to Richard Sharp on Facebook. He says, looks like I take care of my vinyl. I do. Oh, this is, yeah, I mean, a lot of this is stuff I didn't play out that much, so it got better treated than the ones I was caning, like, every set. Hi to Jody Quinn in the Facebook. How you doing? Also James in Tennessee. Remember, if you're watching on Facebook, the stream might get cut off by the copyright police. So it's better to switch to Twitch. Oh, that rhymed. Twitch.tv/JohnBBeta or just go to johnb.tv. seen a post there asking, I've set my Facebook page up as a content creator so you can send like bat tokens. I haven't yet, but I need to look into that. But if you want to send me stuff like that, you can do it on Twitch. You can send bits and those kind of things. But yeah, I didn't want to mess up my Facebook fan page by turning into like a gaming page or something in case like the last 10 years of Facebook account building all just got mashed up. So I need to check on that, but obviously it would make sense for doing this kind of thing. So thank you for the suggestion. What a tune! So how's the visuals looking for everybody? I've got a couple of cameras set up here and the one so you can see the vinyl moving. Edited all of this stuff that you see in the background. I edited all, that took like 2 days straight. And I've done a whole bunch of different ones like that. The different types of drum and bass sets I'm going to be doing regularly like this. But this is the vinyl sessions one. What I'm most excited to do regularly, to be honest, just digging into my record collection and have a little play for a laugh. Yeah, Jack did have a groove, I think we know by now. We also know that house is a feeling, been told that a few times. I think we all know how to put our fucking hands in the air after being told a million times at those things I vaguely remember, nightclubs. Actually, I'm usually the one telling you guys to put your hands up, sorry. Yeah, that last track was on Metro, Matrix's label. I think it's called Carlito's Way. I hope I said Matrix and not Metric there. Love them both, of course, but yeah, the Metro is Matrix's label.
Phase 1.
I've just remembered I've got some new slip mats this week. Of Metalheads, and they're lava ones. Like, how good is that? I've always wanted some Metalhead slip mats, and to have ones, there's the artwork from my record on Metalheads is amazing. They sent me them free, so this is probably sponsored post. Oh, that's a proud moment, that. That's really good. Are very slippy. Can confirm, good slip on these slip mats. Grab your pair at the Metalheads web store right now. Host on Twitch, look like Will, thanks. Yeah. I'm in Maidenhead. I see James on Facebook saying, where am I? I'm in Maidenhead, in my house. Dobre wieczór to the Poland crew. Those of you asking, where's the Chablis? I gave up alcohol about 18 months ago now. So it's just water. Thanks for the subscribe there. That was, I missed the names. It was like Sebastatool or something. Oh no. Oh, there we go. Basti Tool Tool subscribed at tier one. Thank you. Oh, it's so good that this actually works. I'm feeling quite positive about the general Twitch ecosystem and everything. That last one was TB, of course, and this is Calibre. I'm going to have to wrap it up soon. I've been playing for an hour 40, and it's 10 o'clock now, so I don't want to be blasting out the bass, keeping all my neighbours awake. Damn it, I keep hitting my head on the ceiling. I'm going to put my new slip mat on the other one now. Right, one more tune. I think I'll try and yeah. So, do you want LTJ Bookham music, the Pesce rework, or do you want Pesce jazz lick? What do you want? Music by LTJ Bookham or jazz lick by Pesce? Hit me up in the comments. I can see it there. I'll give you a few. The Twitch dashboard. This is good. I'm putting all the records I've played tonight in a separate pile so I don't accidentally play them again. Thanks for the follow, Stanislav2 on Twitch. Okay, so we got a couple of votes for LTJ, one for Jazzlick there. So what we got? Jazzlick or music by Bookham? Ooh, it's looking about 50-50 here. Oh no, we're getting more votes for LTJ Bookham here. It's easier to mix that one, actually. So, oh shit, the chunk song's gonna run out. Always feels so wrong playing this track so speeded up, but it's quite slow. Cool, so this is my last track for tonight. I didn't give anyone advance warning that I was going to be doing this tonight. I just I wanted to check that my streaming setup was working properly, and it was, and I was in a mood, so here we are. So I will now be doing these more regularly. Now that lockdown is over and everyone else has done all their streaming and given up, I am now going to start properly. But this system seems pretty good. So I can do vinyl sessions and normal ones too. Stick my laptop there, nice one. So yeah, thanks everyone for tuning in. It looks like we have people across YouTube and Facebook and Twitch and even on VKontakt in Russia. Be interesting to see what the numbers are. Mike Hollingberry, I see you on YouTube. I was going to wear my mask. This is my friend Mike who actually sent me my amazing respirator mask. I'm going to put it on.
need to work. Don't it need to work very well with the glasses? Shout out to everyone on lockdown. Obviously not very practical talking on a microphone either, is it? This is how I'll be dressed when I'm going back to DJing in the clubs. Tuning in, everybody. This is how you correctly doff a mask such as this in a safe and sanitary way. Cool, I'm going to fade this out. If I leave this song playing, this is the kind of one that will give me a copyright strike. I can just feel it in my bones. So yeah, cool. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. I think that went all right. Technologically, it seems pretty nice and smooth, actually, because what I've got on my iPad in front of me here is Twitch just coming off the internet, kind of how you guys are seeing it with the delay. Because, I don't know, I guess this... Oh, if I move my hand there... I'm trying to wait until that happens. I think you guys are about 10 seconds behind what actually happens. Jay Willy, thanks for the subscribe. Much appreciated. So yeah, this is cool. It's a bit hot up here. Not too good for my hair, but... whatever. Cool, so I think we've finally got proof of concept. It's 4th of July. Lockdown started on March the whatever. Finally there. Well, I was there before, but this is 1080p, 30 frames a second, smooth broadcast quality. Get in there! So, yeah. I have to work out what my schedule's going to be, what works best for everyone. What day and what time and everything based on where you guys all are and all the rest of that. What's all this? Apophanis? Noob? Oh, okay, that's cool. Thanks for the messages that say lube. That's fantastic. It looks like that's what's in my hair, doesn't it? So, yeah, cool. All right, thanks for tuning in, guys. More of these coming soon. Playing normal drum and bass. I don't know. More current stuff. I'm going to do vinyl sessions, just going through my record collection, playing old stuff that I love. New stuff and some sort of mad themed shit as well, just for a laugh. And streams in the studio. And whatever. So, all right. Oh. They don't make them like that anymore. So, yeah, I think Sunday evenings is good for a vinyl session, like for the Sunday sessions. That's when I did my proper last live stream of classic stuff. So I think Sunday nights will make us a vinyl classic set. I won't have to plan it or anything. It'll just be fun to hang out. And maybe, I guess people are going to be going out Friday night. So maybe like one night, maybe Monday or something, I'll do, or Tuesdays, I'll do like other DJ sets. And I'll kind of rotate what they're going to be, but it'll be modern stuff off my Serato. So anyway, thanks very much. John B out.